But Buffy was always fashionable. I think it was one of the first real female heroines that you saw who did not sacrifice fashion for clothes.
We're gonna fit in it with those hips. We have to kill them.
You don't need to see my ID now, do you?
No.
Good.
Read an interview with a vampire, you know, as a black person or just a person of color, is really funny. Because there are times when Louis likes to sit there and critique Lestat and be like, he's so inhumane, he's so awful. And it's like, homie, you owned slaves. You have no leg to stand on in these arguments. And if Lestat was truly the petty ass bitch everyone likes to say he is, he would be using it in every fight. You are a monster, Lestat. A cruel and awful monster. Well, Louis, I only became a monster after I was turned into a monster. You were a monster before you were even turned, so. Excuse me? Your slaves, Louis?
So, Angel's on top again?
What?
Angel or Star?
Oh, Star.
You did cheat just a little bit.
I didn't cheat.
You did just a little bit.
I didn't have to.
What you got in the basket, little girl?
Weapons. We have a close relationship with God.
And you are?
Let's go
to the boudoir.
What if, and just hear me out for a second, you shut them.
I'm putting my life on the line battling the undead. Look, I broke a nail, okay? I'm wearing a press on.
I'm going with B. Then it'll be in forever.
Don't you want your garbage?
What are you doing?
My boyfriend, go away.
Richard, you are?
So not interested.
Evil toenails.
Really?
I can't just be proactive with Pep.
Nope. Not tight enough.
Add it up, it all spells duh.
We're gonna have a blast.
I just wanna be alone and quiet in a room with a chair and a fireplace and a tea cozy. I don't even know what a tea cozy is, but I want one.
You're not a normal girl.
And you are?
Either way, I'm bored, constricted, I never get to shop, and my hair and fingernails still continue to grow.
I wasn't gonna use violence. I don't always use violence. Do I?
The important thing is, you believe that.
Oh,
actually something you're close to.
I never knew you had so much rage in you.
What can I say? I'm the world's best actor.
Second best.
You played me. You played me!
Or witch, as is more accurate. I am not to be trifled
but
with.
Stop talking! Don't interrupt me! Insignificant man.
I am Willow. I am death. If you dare defy me, I will call down my fury, exact fresh vengeance, and make your worst fears come true. Okay?
Queer, half queer, mostly queer, what is it?
Non-discriminating.
There is an ocean between Christ and myself.
Bring it, boy!
Another opera.
Not another opera.
Oh boy, where did we go?
You left without saying goodbye. Again?
How about Rome?
Rome, Italy?
Would you prefer Rome, Wisconsin?
I don't like sleeping there.
I helped save the world, you know.
Like I haven't, yeah, but I've done it a lot more.
Yellow!
You took my Viper.
My Viper now, mate. Oh, right, breaking up. You're breaking up.
Come and stay.
You going out?
Go.
Will you be slaying?
I'm just saying, if Louis hadn't inadvertently caused the fire that got them to obtain Claudia, that whole house dynamic would have been so different.
You will not argue with me, little girl! Now you will go to cover!
I don't gotta do shit you say!
That's it? I'm tired of this! You go out in the front yard, you get yourself a switch!
This is a switch.
It's a branch. Beat a ass.
Now Louis, we do not have to go to such a fire. Claudia, do not get a stick! What is wrong with you?
She needs to learn not to disrespect her elders.
Louis, she is just a teenager going through a rebellious stage. Like, we can send her to coffin.
Well, this is the way that I was taught.
Honestly, that explains so much about you.
Gonna burn this goddamn house right down. If you think you're getting away, I will prove you wrong. I'll take you all the way. Say another song. I'll blow you all away.
Find me.
Your friend Teddy told me where you were hiding.
I'm paying him a little visit earlier today, saying
you should come through in the PR mini skirt. No bra, no panties, no time to flirt. I'm busy collecting.
and gifts from a daddy in Connecticut. Yeah. A chicken sweater and a thread that I couldn't get.
Stop doing this and get inside.
You can't gaslight me. No, you can't gaslight me. You cannot try to tell me that there was a human woman who was attracted to men who had this man fiending for her. Like, I will die for you. Like, anything you want, baby girl, I'll go get it. Like, my breath, I'll take it. This man. And in addition to this man, she had this man who was just as obsessed. This man who literally helped her cover up the murder of his childhood love and childhood best friend. She had these two men, and they both have money. And she went, no. You're trying to tell me that she said no for this guy? This Confederate soldier? This guy who dated his granddaughter? Sorry, great-granddaughter, so I guess it doesn't count. This guy who literally, when she first met, seduced her for some weird, nefarious vampire stuff? This... who lies to her at every turn? No. No. The math isn't mathing. You're literally lying. I do not believe it. Thank you. Next.
So I think Sam and Frodo should have kissed. And my feeling about that is, first of all, how do you know they didn't? You know what I mean? It's a long trek to Mordor.
But I'll admit that I was glad it was over.
I do believe I felt some trepidation when the name Lestat was uttered.
Who?